How common are paraphilias? What are the health benefits of masturbation? Hello to all lovers of psychology and sexuality. Today, we will unveil the sexual curiosities of women. If you are interested in these topics, make sure to subscribe and activate the notification bell to not miss our future videos. Also, leave us comments and share your experiences in the section below. Let's get started. Paraphilias are unusual or atypical sexual desires, such as fetishism or BDSM. Their prevalence varies, but many people have mild or moderate paraphilic interests. Not all paraphilias are problematic or require treatment. Masturbation has several health benefits, such as relieving stress, improving sleep, releasing mood-enhancing endorphins, and helping individuals understand their bodies and sexual preferences. Sexual motivations, the University of Texas, conducted research identifying 237 different motivations for having sex. Interestingly, having children and relieving tension are no longer the main reasons. Other motivations include getting closer to God, burning calories, returning a favor, changing the topic of conversation, and even getting rid of a headache. This study demonstrates that human sexual motivations are extremely complex. MRI studies. MRI studies have shown that the brain areas activated during orgasm are similar in both genders, suggesting that the experience is more similar than previously thought. Multiple orgasms. Some women can experience multiple orgasms in a single sexual session, involving one orgasm after another without a refractory period, enabling continuous pleasure. Smell and attraction. The sense of smell can influence sexual attraction. A person's natural scent, their pheromones, may play a role in sexual chemistry and attraction. Orgasm through thought, rarely. Some people can experience an orgasm through thought without physical stimulation. This is called mental orgasm or contactless orgasm. Orgasms during childbirth. In rare instances, some women experience orgasms during childbirth. This is due to the stimulation of certain nerves and is not something all women experience, but it is a curious and little known phenomenon. Oxytocin and emotional bonding. Oxytocin, known as the love hormone or cuddle hormone, is released during sex and orgasm. It plays a crucial role in the emotional bond between partners. The role of dopamine. In sex, dopamine is a neurotransmitter that plays a key role in desire and reward. During sexual activity, the brain releases dopamine, contributing to the sensation of pleasure and reinforcing the desire for sex. Pelvic floor training. Both men and women can benefit from pelvic floor training to enhance the intensity and control of their orgasms. Exercises like Kegel exercises can strengthen the muscles involved in the sexual response. Polyamory is a form of relationship in which individuals have multiple consensual partners. It can be an option for those who wish to explore intimate relationships with several people simultaneously. Postures and positioning. Experimenting with different postures and positions can influence comfort and pleasure during anal sex. Professional consultation. If any health concerns arise or persistent discomfort is experienced, it is advisable to seek guidance from health professionals, such as doctors or sex therapists. Prostate orgasm. Prostate stimulation can lead to intense orgasms in men, often achieved through anal stimulation, known as the prostate orgasm. Psychology of jealousy. Jealousy is a complex emotion related to possession and competition for a partner. It can arise for various reasons, including concerns about infidelity. Refractory period. Most men experience a refractory period after orgasm, during which they cannot achieve another orgasm or immediate erection. The duration of the refractory period can vary widely among individuals. Relation to pleasure. For some people, anal sex can provide additional pleasure due to the stimulation of nerve endings in the anal area. Male and female sexual response can vary significantly. In general, men tend to experience a longer resolution phase after orgasm, while some women may experience multiple orgasms without a refractory period. Sense of responsibility. The ability to take on responsibilities and commitments in life, whether at work, in a relationship, or in the community, is valued. Sex in water, whether in a pool, jacuzzi, or the sea, can be exciting. But it's important to remember that the body's natural lubricants can disappear in water, making sex uncomfortable. Additionally, water is not a good substitute for lubricant. Sex in space. NASA has investigated how life in space would affect human sexuality. One challenge is gravity, as in a microgravity environment, blood flow and sexual response may change. Research in this field may be crucial for future extended space missions. Sex and pregnancy. Having sexual relations during pregnancy is generally safe, unless otherwise indicated by a doctor. In fact, many couples find that their sex life improves during this period. Sex and longevity. Regular sexual activity has been shown to be associated with a longer life. Endorphins released during orgasm can help reduce stress and strengthen the immune system. Sexuality in Kama Sutra culture. The Kama Sutra, an ancient Hindu text on love and sexuality, provides a detailed insight into sexual positions and erotic techniques. Despite its fame, the Kama Sutra promotes a balanced view of love and pleasure. Simulated orgasms. Some women have admitted to faking orgasms during sexual encounters. This may be due to various reasons, including social pressure or concerns about their partner's satisfaction. Painful coitus syndrome, also known as dyspareunia, is a condition where a person experiences pain during intercourse. It can be caused by various reasons, such as medical, emotional, or physical issues. Lucid dreams are those in which a person is aware they are dreaming and can take control of their dream. Some people report having sexual experiences in lucid dreams. Penis size. There is a wide variety in the size of male genital organs. Although the average is usually around 13 to 15 centimeters when erect, sizes vary significantly. Having a larger penis does not necessarily guarantee greater sexual pleasure for the partner, as satisfaction depends on other factors such as technique and communication. Human sexuality is a fascinating and diverse field that never ceases to amaze us. Sexual curiosities unveil the wonderful complexity of the human experience in the intimate realm. As we explore and understand these facts, it is crucial to remember that each individual is unique in their sexual experience. Respecting and communicating with your partner are the keys to a satisfying and healthy sexual life. Sexual education and understanding are essential tools for fully embracing our sexuality.